This is my living room, and this is generally the room where people spend the most time when they come over, friends and family. So as you can see, I try to keep it clean and nice and tidy for the most part so that everyone's comfortable when they come over. And this is my home office. Like, you know, this may come as a shock to some of you, but I haven't been getting a lot of work done in here lately. Yeah. Yeah, it's time we fix this.
Before we continue, a special thanks to Keeps for sponsoring today's video. Keeps continues to be the leading name in hair loss prevention for men because it offers the most effective solution for retaining as much of your hair as possible. Just ask the millions of guys Keeps has already saved from going bald. I also really like the way Keeps does business. I can meet with a doctor online for utmost discretion and have products sent to my doorstep every 3 months so I never have to stop playing Halo Infinite. Currently, there's only 2 FDA-approved hair loss products on the market, and Keeps offers generic versions of both, making them safe, effective, and affordable. Statistically, 2 out of 3 men do experience some form of hair loss by the time they're 35, but taking preemptive measures is the best line of defense to saving those silky protein fibers of yours, especially because it can take up to 6 months to see results. Just go to keeps.com/bitwit or click the link in the description below to receive 50% off your first order. Give your hair a fighting chance and try Keeps today.
You might be wondering, how the heck did I let this room get this bad? Well, ever since I moved into the office studio, I've been using this room less and less for work. In fact, I probably only spend an hour or two a week in here to do any actual work. And since then, I've kind of just been piling things in here over time, whether it be some of my belongings that really shouldn't be in here, it should be in other areas of the house, or just trash, like actual big pieces of trash, mostly boxes and stuff that I haven't cut down and disposed of properly. So over time, it's really just kind of gotten really out of hand, and I've kept procrastinating on doing anything about it because I don't really use this space much these days to begin with. But I would like to start using this space for something more useful than just a junk/storage pod. For example, my desk area here, I'd like to transform this into more of a nice at-home streaming area. So today I'm going to clean it. I'm gonna restore this room back to working order so that I can actually breathe in it. I can hardly walk in this space. It's looking like an episode of Hoarders in here. I'm gonna take a wild guess and say it's gonna take me at least 4 to 5 hours to clear everything out of here, put everything where it belongs, and really deep clean this room. And even deep clean some of the other items in this room, like my old PC here, my old editing rig. It's pretty filthy. Completely filthified. You can see there's like dust and cat hair in there. What is that, litter? Oh God, it's disgusting. And maybe we'll finally figure out why these fans aren't lighting up and why this fan only spins up sometimes. It's a slow fan. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. I hope you guys are ready for some good deep cleaning time lapses. Oh shit! The office is now clean. It only took me 6 hours to get it to this state, but I think it was worth it. Definitely paid off. I'm gonna give you guys a quick tour of everything and also share my plans and ideas for this room now that it's kind of a blank canvas and I can sort of work in here. So this is, we've got sort of like a his and hers type thing, but obviously it's just me, so it's like a mine and mine, whatever. So I could just do something simple and do like a carbon copy and make each setup exactly the same, but that's kind of boring. I want to switch it up. So I had an idea to do an all white themed setup here and an all black themed setup there. And earlier before I started cleaning, obviously you guys saw that none of this stuff was here. It was just a bunch of documents and it was an absolute disaster. But now you can see I've got Hotline 2.0 here with a nice gaming monitor, some peripherals and stuff. But obviously this is all gonna change. If it's gonna be an all white setup, everything's gonna have to be replaced. And I'm actually doing an all white build with Seuss pretty soon in white. Everything's gonna be white. And so I think I'm gonna use that build actually. I'm just gonna use that build for this setup. This is also gonna be like the main streaming setup. Previously, when I was streaming from home, I was streaming from this setup, which was fine, except the background sucks because I've got all this like networking stuff. Oh, I put all the networking stuff on a little table here. That's probably gonna get changed out as well, but at least it's all off the floor now. Just ignore cable management for now. Yeah, like you can see like the wires coming down. I'm gonna have to hide that as well. Get like a cable channel going all the way down at some point. But this is just a weird corner to have as a background for my streams. And because I do like a lot of like just chatting, I don't only do gaming. My face cam is full screen a lot of the time. So the background is kind of important. If I was just a small little thumbnail, it wouldn't matter so much. So this is gonna be the main streaming setup. As far as monitors go, right now I just have this LG Ultra Gear. It's a really nice monitor. I think it's 1440p, 144 hertz, but it's only 27 inches, a little bit small for my liking. I'm probably gonna replace this with like a 4K 144 hertz display. And I'm not sure exactly which one to go with yet. I wish the Corsair Xenion that just launched was 4K. I'm sure they're gonna launch a 4K one at some point. I really like that display, but it's only 1440p. So I'm probably gonna go with maybe either like an Asus like Swift panel or maybe even like a Gigabyte Aorus. Cause I know both of those companies have 32 inch 4K gaming monitors. But on top of that, I'm also gonna get a companion display because if I'm streaming, I want at least two displays. I'd like to have three, but there's just not quite enough room on this desk unless I did like one companion display here vertically and then had another one mounted on top. But I generally don't like the top mounted, like the vertically stacked displays. It just hurts my neck and stuff. I'll probably keep the PC on the right side and have the companion monitor on the left mounted vertically. As far as this setup goes, it's gonna be all black. Oh, by the way, you can see that the PC is now really clean and I got the RGB working. Turns out it was just a firmware update for the Lighting Node Pro that all these fans are connected to. I could have done that a long time ago, but I did not fix the slow fan. He's just gonna stay his special self for now. It's not really doing much harm to the airflow, I would imagine. There's still plenty of fans going. But that PC is probably going to get replaced, A, because it's not black enough. I mean, it is fairly black, but I just want an excuse or a reason to build an all-black system that's a bit more modern as well. So that's B, is that the hardware is a little dated. I mean, it's still a fantastic PC. It's got a Core i9-7960X, 16 cores, 32 threads, and there was previously an RTX 2060 in here. I don't know why. I think it used to be something much faster, and I had to like use that card for something else, never swapped it back. But anyway, I just replaced it temporarily with an RTX 2080 because that's what I had on hand here at home. Anyway, I'm gonna replace this PC with something all black. Should be cool, so stay tuned for that video. As far as like what I'm thinking monitor-wise, probably very similar to what I'm gonna have over here. Like the main display is gonna be a 32-inch 4K gaming monitor, and then I'm gonna have a secondary display that's probably mounted vertically to save space. I will probably put the PC on the right side so that it's just a bit more visible. It's kind of just hard to see, like when you come in, kind of gets obfuscated by this rig over here. So I'll probably just swap positions with this display or the companion monitor and PC, boom, probably do another custom keyboard, or I could just use, the GMMK Pro keyboard that I built recently, the all black ones, like black and gray. Oh yeah, and then obviously like, you know, the Wave 3 microphone here on the boom pole is gonna go over here because it's a streaming setup. And I also forgot to mention, obviously I'll have like a camera, like probably a mirrorless or DSLR and some Elgato lights and stuff like that, key lights. Cable management, ignore that as well. Cause I mean, again, all this stuff is gonna get swapped out anyway. It's no point in making it all nice and tidy if I'm just gonna remove all of it. So yeah, that's pretty much how I'm envisioning this. Obviously this is still gonna be ready for gaming as well. Even though I'll mainly be gaming on that system. If let's say I have a friend come over, we want to play together. I also need to get another Vertigear chair to match this guy, because right now there's no chair here. Let's talk about the rest of the office though, shall we? So these are the original blinds that that were here when I moved into the house originally, like 3 years ago, 2.5, 3 years ago. And they're like really old. It's like really, really old janky blinds. Like they have a hard time opening. I always feel like I'm gonna break it. It's just dated, doesn't look that great. So I'll probably replace that with like some roller shades or whatever. For the networking, I'm thinking replacing this because this is like much better than what it was with all this stuff on the floor. But I think what I want to do is get like a tall and narrow shelving unit. And to save space, again, I could probably cut the footprint of this in half, stick it in the corner and then have like, you know, maybe like 4 or 5 shelves and I can rearrange all that stuff on there. And then over here we have the couch. So this is actually a futon. And before I started cleaning today, it wasn't even set up. It was like kind of disassembled and really dirty. It was like, you know, standing up and stuff in the room. But I'm really glad that it's set up now because right now I have my roommate Ian is actually playing Overwatch right now in his room on the other side of the wall. That's the only other bedroom in this house. So now that that room's occupied by him, if my other friends wanna crash here, like they can just pull this out. But it is kind of bulky. It's kind of bulky, it takes up quite a bit of room. So what I'm thinking is at some point down the line, I'll probably replace this with like a Murphy bed. If you guys don't know what a Murphy bed is, it's basically like it stands up vertically, looks like a closet. It looks like a closet, but then you open the doors and you can like fold down the bed or whatever. Sometimes it doesn't even have doors. And it's a great way to save space if you want a bed in your room. So I'll probably do something like that. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this couch. I don't know. Anyone want this couch? No, you don't want this couch. It's all scratched up and stuff from my cats. Assholes. This corner is kind of just unfinished, obviously. Like previously, before I moved into the studio that I'm in now, I had a bunch of nice cabinets. Like they were wall-mounted cabinets, and then also like a large cabinet over here that filled this little nook perfectly. It's actually a closet, but obviously I took out all the shelving and the doors. But I had plenty of storage here before I moved to the studio. Once I moved to the studio, I moved all of that cabinetry to the studio, where it is, of course, much needed, but I also need storage here now. So I think I'm just gonna buy the exact same unit that I did because it worked out so well the first time. This is just another PC, another like really high-end PC that I have no use for right now. So I'll probably just take it back to the studio where it'll join the other unloved PCs in my collection. Pokemon cards, a very sad way to present my Pokemon cards to the world. I'm thinking I kind of want to get like a glass display case for these where I can just like show them off. It'll look nice and probably save a lot of space if I can get like a narrow one with a couple shelves in it and stuff. I think the rest of it just boils down to like decor. The walls are very blank in here. There's like nothing on any of the walls, so it looks kind of empty and dull. I'll probably get some posters. Maybe I'll just run a few posters, like frame posters, like nice ones, all the way across the wall. That way it'll also be sort of a backdrop, a nice backdrop to look at when I'm streaming. Over here, maybe, I don't know, maybe like a nice framed piece of art, pictures. I'm not sure. If you guys have any ideas, let me know. I don't know if I want to go too crazy with RGB in this room. I mean, it is going to be a streaming room, but it's also going to be like a work office, so I don't need it to look all gamered out, if you will, for lack of a better phrase. Oh, and the last thing, plants. I definitely want some plants in here. It's just too, there's a lot of hardware, and I love hardware, but it needs some greenery. This room needs a bit of life. There'll probably be fake plants though, because my cats will eat any real plants in the house, which is why all the plants in my house are fake. Oh, and you might be wondering what happened to all of the crap that was in here. All my belongings that belong here at the house were put away in their proper places. However, here we are in the dining room. This, all this crap that's on the table, this is all the tech stuff that was in the office that has no use here. So I'm gonna be bringing all that back to the studio. And as far as all the boxes, shipping boxes and packaging, that is all dominated my other living room, the family room, whatever this room's called. And then this is like stuff that's like getting donated, like old clothes that was in the office, stuff that's gonna go in the garage, like this rug that I bought that I didn't like. Anyone need a rug? But yeah, that's what happened to all of that stuff. At least it's not in the office anymore. Everything's on its way to its proper place. And I think I'm done with this video. So thank you guys for watching. If you guys have any ideas, as always, feel free to leave them down below. Toss a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Get subscribed for more tech content on the way. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Girl. Girl. Why are you hanging out here with all the trash? Does that mean you want me to throw you away too? A little dumpster kitty? Anyone want a cat?